Okay, I'm gonna try this in English and then in Spanish. I'm gonna turn it over to Madam Mayor, and then we're gonna turn it over to the President of the League of Cities, and then to Mayor Benami from North Miami to wrap things up, and then we'll open it for questions. Good morning, everyone. It's my honor and privilege to have convened this group of mayors from different parts of Miami-Dade County and the mayor of Miami-Dade County to have a roundtable discussion on issues related to Haiti and to Cuba. Joining me today are Mayor Josh Fuller from Bay Harbor Island, Mayor Sally Phillips from South Miami, Mayor Mike Davey from Key Biscayne, City Clerk and the only elected City Clerk in Miami-Dade County, other than the County Clerk, Vanessa Joseph from North Miami, Councilman Tony Fernandez from Miami Lakes, Mayor Jose de la Cruz from Hialeah Gardens, Mayor Anthony DeFilippo from North Miami Beach, Mayor Joseph Corradino from Pinecrest, who's also the president of the Miami-Dade League of Cities, and Mayor Philippe Benamin from North Miami, and Mayor Omar Nickerson from El Portal. We are here united as one voice and as one group, and we are going to be focusing on things that we want from the United States government. I'm going to let the county mayor talk about specific asks of the President of the United States, but I'm going to focus my talking points on issues related to Cuba, and then I'm going to have Mayor Benami talk about the issues that we as a group agree on that need to be taken care of with regard to Haiti. The first thing that we agreed as a coalition of mayors is that the internet is a critical need in Cuba. Mayor J.C. Bermudez articulated very, very eloquently when he said that you cannot have sovereignty in a country without liberty. And you can only have liberty if people have the ability to express themselves. And one of the things that we're seeing is the Cuban government choking the ability for its people to be able to get images out of the brutal repression that is happening every single day in Cuba. So we are imploring the United States to do everything in their power, everything, to get much-needed, reliable internet access into the island. And I think it's important because a lot of people have said it, but I think most of the people that are saying it have been Cuban Americans who have been standing on this issue. So I think it's important that we have this broad coalition, diverse coalition, men and women, Republican Democrats, that are standing together to ask the White House to do this. I think the second thing that we agreed was that the Cuban military and that specifically individual members of the Cuban military that carry out the orders of the Cuban government and repress the Cuban people and beat the Cuban people and harm the Cuban people, that the United States of America do everything in its power to ensure that they will be met, that those actions will be met with serious and severe consequences, whether they be prosecutions, whatever stream of consequences the United States in its broad array of powers can bring to bear on these actors who are systematically beating their own people. I'm going to say these in Spanish briefly, and then I'm going to turn it over to the county mayor for her thoughts. Es un gran honor estar aquí conjunto con este grupo de alcaldes diverso de todo el condado de Miami-Dade. Nosotros somos hombres, mujeres, republicanos, demócratas, de diferentes razas. Estamos aquí todos unidos bajo mensajes que tienen que ver con la isla de Haití y la isla de Cuba. Yo voy a hablar sobre los temas relacionados con Cuba y el alcalde de North Miami va a hablar sobre los temas relacionados con Haití. Y la alcaldesa del condado va a hablar sobre la expectativa de lo que deseamos del presidente de los Estados Unidos. Nosotros estamos completamente unidos como una comunidad diversa en recalcar y enfatizar la necesidad para acceso al internet en Cuba. El alcalde J.C. Bermudez dijo que un país no puede ser soberano si no existe la libertad. Así que una contienda que dándole acceso del internet a Cuba es una violación de la soberanía de Cuba es algo que no tiene sentido porque no hay soberanía en países que no le dan la libertad a su pueblo. Así que le estamos pidiendo a los Estados Unidos que hagan todo lo posible bajo su control para establecer eso tan necesitado, para que las imágenes y el video de la represión inimaginable que está sucediendo en Cuba en este momento se puede ver y llevar a la luz para que la comunidad internacional entienda lo que está sucediendo. Punto número dos, en cual estábamos en completo acuerdo, que los militares que están siguiendo los órdenes de sus superiores en Cuba tienen que sufrir una consecuencia directa y que los Estados Unidos tienen que utilizar todas las herramientas posibles para asegurar que individualmente ellos sufren consecuencias. Y tercero, estábamos de acuerdo que utilizando el OAS necesitamos elevar este tema a la comunidad internacional para que ellos puedan continuar a poner presión y llamar atención a este tema tan importante. Ahora voy a darle la palabra a la alcaldesa de condado, Daniela Levencava, y después al alcalde de North Miami. Gracias.
Gracias, alcalde. Thank you, everyone, for... Thank you, everyone, for being here together, united as we are in this community, for the struggles, for the fight for freedom, for the safety and security of our brothers and sisters in the Caribbean on the islands of Haiti and Cuba. Yesterday, I sent a letter to President Biden, and I called upon him to listen to the voices of our community. Our community is uniquely positioned as the closest to those islands, as the one that has benefited from the diaspora from those two nations, as the one that stands in solidarity fighting for the well-being of the people and the freedom for those people. We say to you, Mr. President, we need you to step up. We need you to do what other administrations have not done. We need you to listen to our voices and take concrete actions to protect our neighbors, to protect our shores, to protect the Cuban and Haitian communities here in Miami-Dade and everyone who stands united. There are several important things that you can do, Mr. President, and these will be addressed in more detail. We need your help with communication. Free communication is essential to both of these countries during these difficult times. We need you to make sure that the voices of people in those countries are heard, that they are not squelched, and that human rights are honored in both of these countries. We need your help to promote stability for the people of Haiti who have been for so long fighting for a better leadership. And in Cuba, we need you to stand with us to demand liberty and freedom for those fighting for 62 long years. So we're here, we're ready to receive you, we're ready for the conversation, and we're ready for your action. Thank you. Aquí estamos unidos como siempre en la comunidad de Miami-Dade con el apoyo de los líderes electorales y de la comunidad, diciendo que necesitamos el apoyo de nuestro presidente más que anteriormente. Nosotros estamos en lo más afectados por la nación de lo que está pasando en el Caribe, especialmente en Haití y Cuba. Y también tenemos el liderazgo aquí unidos que sabemos lo que está pasando y nosotros queremos hablar con el presidente para decir lo que sabemos y lo que es necesario seguir adelante por la seguridad y para la libertad. Y nosotros sabemos exactamente lo que está pasando y tenemos las familiares, tenemos los que están conectados con las personas en Haití y Cuba y también las familias acá que están esperando noticias buenas durante la lucha y el sufrimiento. Entonces, unidos, te suplicamos atención y asistencia lo antes posible, especialmente con la comunicación por el Internet, con la seguridad y con acciones directas para beneficiar a ellos y a nosotros. Gracias.
Before recognizing the mayor of North Miami, I want to recognize Mayor Corradino, who is the president of the Miami-Dade League of Cities.
Thank you, Mayor. I believe this is an important day. This isn't just about our Haitian brothers and sisters, our Cuban brothers and sisters. This is a cross-section of the elected leaders in Miami-Dade County that have come together to support each other in this time of need. We're one of the most diverse counties in all of America, and certainly one that will be most impacted by these situations. This is about freedom, and we believe we needed the United States to intervene and do what it can do to assist in this situation. Thank you, Mayor.
Mayor. Thank you very much. Today is a day for actions, not talk, because we've been talking forever. Cuba is still the way it is, and Haiti is still the way it is. The country been in chaos when it comes to Haiti for the past 2 years. And the U.S. government is responsible for that. Today, we urge the Biden administration to step up and engage in a dialogue that's going to lead to a new government with a new first minister that's going to lead the country and stop the killing of the people and engage and free and fair election in the country. That's what we need. No talk, action. And we want the Biden administration to pay more attention on what's going on in the region. It's Cuba forever. It's Haiti forever. And we don't know who's next tomorrow. That means it's a day of action. Thank you. Nous dit que Haïti, son pays qui est en chaos pendant plus passé 2 ans, et nous rend administration, U.S. administration, non, responsable pour la situation qui est en Haïti. C'est peut-être ça, nous avons demandé président Joe Biden avec l'administration pour le step up, pour permettre que un vrai dialogue en Haïti connaît. Pour nous gagner un nouveau premier ministre, un nouveau gouvernement qui pourra empêcher les gens de continuer à mourir en d'un pays et permettre que nous ayons une free élection qui fait pour élus capables de venir et redresser la situation pays. Nous n'avons pas besoin d'aucune intervention militaire en Haïti. That's not what we need right now. Si gouvernement américain pas step up, then Haïti pral tomber dans plus chaos et nous pas connaît qui ça pral gagner en après. Donc jodi an son jour pour action, c'est pas parler en pile. Merci.
Thank you so much. And before opening it up for questions, I just want to conclude by reiterating that we need United States, we need US leadership in the region now. We have seen that Russia and China are not afraid to intervene in conflicts in their own region and have continually intervened in our region. And, you know, it's scary to think that the United States is taking such a passive approach when those countries are taking such an active approach. Quiero simplemente concluir diciendo que nosotros que necesitamos liderazgo de los Estados Unidos ahora. Hemos visto como países como Rusia y como China han intervenido no solo en su propia región, pero en nuestra región también. Nosotros no podemos hacer pasivo afrontando esas amenazas de esos países tampoco. Gracias. I'm going to open it up for questions, English and Spanish, if anyone has questions. Absolutely. And I spoke about this issue last night with Senator Rubio, and he said that, you know, right now Miamians can go to Cuba. Their flights are packed every single day with people going to Cuba. What they can't do is they can't stay in hotels, which benefit the Cuban regime. They can go and stay in an Airbnb, which is something that's allowed. And so there is sort of a misperception right now that Cubans and Miamians are not allowed to go to Cuba and help and support their brothers and sisters in Cuba. That's happening every single day, and there's full flights. What's not happening is any sort of real help to the Cuban people who are having to fight this dictatorship with sticks and rocks. No entiendo la pregunta. Oh, por supuesto que sí. Por supuesto que sí. Yo creo que la represión ha llegado a puntos que se compara con lo que hemos visto en países en el Medio Oriente. Es brutal, barbaric, algo que nosotros... Hay reportes, si no son confirmados, de que están cortándole orejas a la persona, cortándole dedos. Yo he oído en las redes sociales sin confirmación que eso está sucediendo, pero lo que sí hemos visto, niños muertos, hemos visto personas que han entrado a la casa de uno y sin discriminación, porque ellos no se pueden defender. No es como si están enfrentando a alguien con una arma de fuego, se están enfrentando a alguien completamente sin habilidad de defenderse. Lo están matando, asesinando ahí mismo. Así que yo creo que estas confrontaciones continuas, si Dios quiere, van a unir la comunidad internacional, que yo creo que se tiene que involucrar más. Y eso también es a base del liderazgo de los Estados Unidos. Para no entrar en política de demócratas republicanos, la administración anterior con respecto a Venezuela sí creó una coalición de países internacionales. Sí creó una coalición de países internacionales para intervenir en Venezuela.
Solamente también quiero enfatizar que por eso necesitamos el Internet, porque tenemos que saber lo que está pasando, y si no tenemos la información, estamos ciegos.
Pidiendo libertad. Por supuesto, yo creo que por eso la llamada de hoy en particular es para recibir este tipo de liderazgo que hemos visto históricamente de los Estados Unidos en varias ocasiones, y también la necesidad del presidente involucrarse en estos temas directamente, concretamente. Mira, hay todo, la palabra intervención es una palabra interesante, porque tiene todo tipo de significativo. Pero la realidad es que siempre hay intervenciones. O sea, desde el punto de vista de que si nosotros tratamos de restablecer internet, servicios de internet, eso es una intervención. Si desde el punto de vista de Cuba, ellos van a decir que es una violación de su soberanía. Así que hay varias formas en cual puede haber intervención. Pero yo creo que lo importante es que los militares en Cuba se sienten que va a haber repercusiones por las acciones que ellos están tomando. En este momento no creo que ellos se sienten que tienen ningún tipo de miedo sobre lo que están haciendo. Y eso es algo que los Estados Unidos tiene que entrar en esa conversación. Y acuérdate que esto no solo es de Cuba. Yo creo que eso es otra parte en cual el grupo de Estados Unidos. Esto afecta a los Estados Unidos, pero afecta a toda la región. Todo el mundo está mirando las acciones o la no acción de los Estados Unidos, juzgando a los Estados Unidos. Y los actores provocatorios no van a parar con un país de Cuba. Si ellos ven que los Estados Unidos no actúa, eso es un mensaje a ellos, que ellos pueden continuar a provocar en diferentes partes del mundo. Así que esto es importante no solo para este tema, es importante para las acciones que toman los Estados Unidos con respecto al mundo. I'll get back to that.
To underscore the importance of the internet and the connection, it's not just for the people inside Cuba who are communicating about the situation, but it's for all of us who are listening and waiting. And without the internet, we are blind to what is happening in that country. And to emphasize the point that Mayor Suarez made, this is an international crisis beyond the borders of these two islands and the United States. It is not only a Caribbean response that is needed, but a hemispheric response that is needed. We are all affected, and we need to move together, and we need the United States to take the lead. Well, efforts are being made through the FCC and elsewhere to explore, but we have to be very sure that those methods of communication will not be sabotaged, will not be taken over and used for other purposes. So it's a very delicate matter. And at this point, we know that the internet has been compromised.
Yeah, and I would agree that it could be done that way, and it may be done that way. I think the question that he was asking, and we'll end after this, unless anybody else wants to say anything, is the word intervention is sort of a hot button word. But it's a very broad word that has a lot of meaning. And, you know, establishing internet in a foreign country, by that foreign country, they're gonna take the position that that's intervention. I think the idea here is that what is happening in Cuba matters in terms of U.S. leadership in the world. You know, those who provoke the United States and who are intervening themselves in this hemisphere are watching what we do or don't do to decide what they're going to do in other parts of the world. And I think that's also important.
I want to end with this. These are not just attacks on Haitians and Cubans. These are attacks on Americans. This is an attack on our country, and we need to treat it as such.